Hey guys, today we're taking a look at the updated version of Doodly. I have reviewed Doodly so many times on this channel, and if you've been with me for a while, you know I'm a big fan of it. This video is not sponsored. They don't even know I'm making it, but Doodly has made some updates that we haven't looked at yet, so I want to highlight them for you today. I like Doodly so much, I made my own course on it called the Doodly Genius Track. You can snap it up at jenjager.com if you're interested. But if you don't know what Doodly is, you don't know a lot about it, it is a whiteboard animation platform that comes with a bunch of illustrations. So you can make whiteboard animations like this one where a hand comes in and draws in your image and then it goes ahead and erases it. But what I really love about Doodly is that you can bring in your own images. So you can really get custom looks and you're not just limited to these like illustrations that come with Doodly. You can bring in anything. You can take a photograph and you can color it in. I mean, there's so many different things that you can do with this platform. I'm a big fan of it. But let's focus on what's new with Doodly, because there are some interesting features that they've added that I think really enhance the already great functionality of this platform. So first I'm going to start by creating a new video. And what's great about Doodly is that you can make a whiteboard video, a chalkboard video, or a glassboard video, or you can have it be a custom color. I'm going to go glassboard. I think that's kind of fun. Let's give this guy a name here. Let's pick our resolution. I'm going to go 1080p, but you can make square versions for Facebook or Instagram, or you can put in custom dimensions if you so choose. And let's hit create. Here is our platform. I'm gonna give you a quick tour in case you've never seen this before. Here are all of our assets. These are different scenes that we can incorporate in our project. Now, I also have what's called the Rainbow Add-on, which is an add-on feature where you can have color illustrations as opposed to just black and white. Now, again, if you're bringing in your own images, they can be color or black or white. I'm gonna turn off the Rainbow Add-on. And this is what you get. You get more of a traditional whiteboard style video. Let's head on over to the next tab, which is all of our characters. And you can search for different types of characters here. So people who have different roles, like tennis, Christmas. Over here are props. So these are different illustrations that come with Doodly. Again, you can turn them into color if you have the Rainbow add-on. Next up is text, and you can search for text. There's a lot of different fonts that come with Doodly, and you can import your own fonts by hitting this plus sign. There's music tracks that come pre-licensed for you, and there are sound effects now, which is something we're going to talk about today. And then there's the marketplace where you can buy packages of illustrations to fit your needs. Here in the center of your screen is your canvas where you'll be building your animation. So this is where you drop all of your illustrations. Over here on the right is all of your actions. So as we add elements to our project, you'll see a lot of options pop in over here on the right side of the screen. And then down here at the bottom is what is called our timeline. So this is where we can build scene after scene after scene. Right now, we clearly just have the one scene right here. So now let's start dropping some images into our canvas here so I can show you what's new in Doodly. I'm gonna head over to the characters tab and I'm gonna turn on the rainbow add-on so everybody's in color. And let's make sort of like a musical scene here. So I'm gonna search singer and I'm just gonna start dropping in characters that look like they're having fun singing. So now that we've got our people dropped in, let me show you one of the new features here in Doodly that I think is really helpful and exciting, and it's about alignment. We can now align really easily our characters or any other objects we drop into our project by right-clicking them and then selecting, let's say for instance, align bottom. And now this character is down toward the bottom of the screen. If I wanted him toward the top, I could align him to the top. But in addition to just aligning a single character, you can align multiple. So I'm going to eyeball where I think I want all of these characters to be in one even row. And now I can select each of them over here in my Actions tab by holding down Command if you're on a Mac or Control if you're on a PC. I've got them all selected. I'm gonna right click and let's say Align Middle. And now they've all snapped into perfect alignment. And I can even move them around as one unit. So that's one new feature that Doodly has recently added that I think adds to the already impressive functionality of this program. Let's keep going. All right, next up, we've got this garden scene that I just built. So another feature that Doodly has recently added is the ability to lock objects in place. If you've ever worked with a design program like, I don't know, Canva, where sometimes you're clicking around and it's so frustrating because you accidentally move something you wanted to leave in place, you don't have that problem anymore with Doodly. All you have to do is right click and select lock. And now I cannot move this plant, but I can move other things instead. All right, now that we've got more of a complex scene built here, let's see what it's gonna look like when it animates in. So to do that, I'm just gonna head on up to show preview at the top of the screen here, and we get a preview of our scene being built. So you saw that the background comes in first, then our two characters, and then our lavender plant. If we wanted to change the order of that, we could just head on over to our actions menu over here and drag, let's say, our lavender up just below the rest of our scene. And now we've changed the order in which they draw it. All right, now let me show you another new feature that Doodly has added. Let's add this dancing character. And I'm going to show you how she gets drawn on here by hitting the preview button. Now, if I wanted her to get drawn on and then erase, I can set Doodly to do that. I would just select her here, head over to settings, and then draw my attention down to exit animation. Right now it's at none. And I'm going to hit erase and hit apply. And let's preview that again and see what happens. So she is drawn on and immediately she gets erased. But Doodly has made a tweak to this feature that I think is really exciting, in that you can delay how long it takes before that character is erased, because before it would draw on and then erase automatically. Now you can add a delay time to that feature. So again, select it on our character. Let's head up to settings. And let's add a delay on that exit animation and hit apply, and let's preview it. This is super important if you have a voiceover that you've added to your video, which you can do here in Doodly, and you're trying to time out the animation with a voiceover. This is such a great feature, and I'm really glad that they finally got around to adding it, because it was definitely something I felt like was missing in Doodly. And the last feature that's new that I'm super excited about can also be found under settings. You can now add sound effects when an illustration is drawn on or when it's erased. All right, let's preview that. While I really do love this new added feature and I think it's a great idea, I am surprised by the sound effects in here. Like, I really think there needs to be a marker, like squeaking sound effect, or a chalkboard sound effect, and then maybe an erasing sound effect. I'm really surprised that those aren't included in the Doodly library. But like what I always say, the magic of this platform isn't really in the assets that come with Doodly, it's in the functionality of it, in that you can bring in your own assets, including sound effects. So if you found a sound effect anywhere else online that you really liked, you can import it into Doodly and incorporate it into your animations. This platform, like I always talk about, is so great in that you can bring in your own stuff, create custom paths so your hand is really drawing on exactly in a way that you would naturally draw. I think that's a great function. There's a camera function so you can like zoom in or zoom out on your frame. I love that you have the different background animations where you can make a custom background. You can import your own background into a shot. You have the glass board with the hand actually facing the camera as opposed to facing away from the camera. You have the traditional whiteboard or the chalkboard. You can really achieve a lot of different looks in this platform, which is why I recommend it all the time. If you want a more in-depth tutorial about Doodly, I've got a few of them down in the description. And if you want that crash course, the Doodly Genius Track, check it out at my website, jenjager.com. You guys, did you like this tutorial? Are you excited about the new features in Doodly? Let me know in the comments. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Make sure you hit that subscribe button so you never miss a future upload. Thanks for hanging out today. I will see you again.